What's up, guys? On today's episode, will the ZR2 start when it's about 5 below outside and the wind chill is about 25 below out? A sick day rides in the balance. The tension is very high. No block heater anywhere, not plugged in. About negative 12, negative 11 in that neighborhood. So we're gonna see if this thing's gonna light off. It's been sitting out here for 14 hours at this temperature. All right, so like I said, the truck hasn't been plugged in. I did run anti-gel in the fuel. So I'm gonna remote start it because I'm pretty ruthless, and we'll see if it lights off. Hopefully it starts, because otherwise I gotta call in sick. So that's about as brutal of a cold start video as I can make for you guys. The last time it was that cold in this area, it was 1994, was the last time we went a full 24-hour day with a below zero high temperature. The wind chill when I started the truck up was between 20 and 25 below zero. The truck doesn't have a block heater in it. I didn't use any battery warmer. I didn't use any oil pan warmer. I don't have any of that stuff. I wanted to see what the truck would do. I wanted to know what the threshold was when this thing wasn't gonna start, and chances are I'm never gonna see that in my climate. If I was leaving it outside at that temperature consistently, absolutely I would plug it in, but like I said, this has happened once in 25 years. So chances of that happening again is maybe once or twice in that truck's lifetime. As far as preparation for the truck, the only thing I did do was I put Standadyne performance formula, which is like an anti-gel and a fuel system lubricator, in the fuel tank. I ran about 1.5 times what it recommended on the side of the bottle, and I had no problem. In the days that followed, and even during that day when I drove it around, I didn't have any issues with my DEF at all. My DEF didn't freeze. I didn't have any issues with the DEF heater. Everything worked like it was supposed to. With that said, about 2 weeks ago, I did have another issue with the truck. 2 weeks ago, we got hit with about a foot of snow, and I was out and about in that foot of snow. And I just set out from where I was coming from, headed home, and this is about an hour drive or so. And I was about half a mile from where I started, and the truck popped up with a battery saving mode active message on the driver information center. For those of you that don't know what battery saving mode is on a GM product, it doesn't let you run the air conditioning or the rear defrost. Those are the only two that I've come across, but basically it turns off any like high load electrical items to save battery power. So naturally, when I saw that message, the next thing I did was I went through on my driver information center and brought up the battery voltage. Well, the battery voltage when I'm running down the road was only 11 volts, and it was holding, so I kept driving the truck. So I made it, I don't know, 3/4 of the way home, at which point the battery voltage started to slowly drop. Once it made it to 10.7, the battery light came on the dash, and it got rather interesting because, like I said, there's a foot of snow on the ground. I'm on a four-lane highway and there's like Ford Fiestas in front of me and, you know, Focuses and small cars, stuff like that, that are doing about 25 miles an hour. The left lane is complete trash. There's a foot of snow in the left lane. And my battery voltage is at 10.5 volts. So I'm like freaking out on the way home. Am I gonna make it? Am I not gonna make it? Because if I don't make it, I know every tow truck in the immediate area is tied up because they're pulling people out of ditches. And it's 10 degrees outside. I can't run the truck because I'm not gonna have any battery voltage. So therefore, it's gonna get rather cold. So luckily I did make it home. I made it home with about, I think the battery was at 9.5 volts when I pulled into the driveway. I had a foot of snow in the driveway and I had the truck in all-wheel drive, and I flicked it over to four-wheel drive and the transfer case didn't have enough voltage to even shift. So in all-wheel drive, I did make it up the driveway, made it into the garage, put the battery on the charger, waited overnight, woke up the next day and pulled the battery off the charger, fired the truck up, and I turned on, you know, the front defrost, rear defrost, heated seats, headlights, basically everything in the truck. I turned it on just to see what the battery voltage did, and I went outside and started clearing out my driveway. After about 10 minutes or so, I came back in and checked on the truck, and battery saving mode was active again, brought up the battery voltage, and it was around 11 volts again. So I shut the truck down, put it back on the charger, called the dealer, let them know the situation, and took the truck to the dealer. I got a loaner. They gave me a 2019 Trail Boss Silverado, which was pretty nice to drive around in a foot of snow. But anyway, make a long story short, the alternator went bad. So they replaced the alternator. They also did a reflash of the body control module because there had been some updates to the body control module programming since the truck had been built. So now, like every day when I get in the truck, one of the first things I do naturally is check the battery voltage, because after almost being stranded in a foot of snow and 10 degree weather, you're gonna check it. So for the cold start that you guys saw, the truck had a brand new alternator on it, works fine, but that's the second possible almost stranded issue I've had in the past 3,000 miles. I do really, really like the truck. I would like to take the truck on, you know, a 8 or 10 hour drive someday possibly. But at this point, I don't know that I trust it. If I could go 10,000 miles without having a major, like, you're gonna be stranded issue, I would take the truck on a long drive, but I don't really feel comfortable driving the thing more than 3 or 4 hours at this point because I don't really trust it. Here's the thing. So my truck has had a few issues like I've told you guys, but my dad's truck has been perfect. He's done literally nothing to it. He's changed the oil, put diesel fuel and DEF in it, and had zero issue with it whatsoever. So naturally, every time I have an issue, my dad kind of freaks out a little, but hopefully, Dad, yours is gonna be all right. We'll see. So hopefully this video answers the question for you guys. Will the truck start when it's below zero? And like you guys saw, as long as your glow plugs, battery, and your fuel isn't gelled, you should be in good shape. You shouldn't have much of a problem. If I was gonna leave it outside consistently at that temperature, absolutely I would get a block heater. But like I said, it's only been this cold around here once in the past 25 years. So chances of that truck seeing that temperature ever again is pretty slim, especially when you consider the fact that it sits in the garage overnight most of the time. But I left it outside just to see, would it do it? So that's the update on my truck. That's the update on my dad's truck. These trucks will, the 2.8 Duramax will start when it's below zero outside without a block heater, as you guys saw. That's it for right now, that's all I got. But if you guys like the video, hit like. You want to see more content? Hit subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys.